lightweight couples travel trailers under 30 feet is all the rage. Behind me is a newer floor plan from Jayco, and I'm super excited to share it with everybody. This is the 2025 Jayco J-Feather, the model 27MK. We're taking a look at the outside features and inside features, and we're starting in 3, 2, 1. Hey everyone again, welcome back to another video. Today I am super excited. I love Jayco, I love being in Indiana, and I love couples travel trailers that really just check off all these boxes. Before I begin, let's say hi to Will. Hey Will!
Hey guys!
How's it going today?
It's going good. Guys, I'm so excited to take a look at this Jayco. I think it's going to be a really, really good floor plan. And I'm excited to be back here at the PDI Center.
Here's what I will say, Will. It's a very unique floor plan.
It's
not
it
your
is.
Cookie cutter style design.
Right.
Model is 27MK Jayco J-Feather. Did I say J-Feather or did I say J-Flight?
I think you might have said J-Flight.
Unreal. The actual tip length is 33 feet 2 inches. We have a dry weight of 7,305 pounds. Hitch weight of 800 pounds. 55 gallons of fresh water, 61 gallons of gray water, 30.5 gallons of black water. This is the Jayco J-Feather. J-Feather is a step above a J-Flight, but it's made to be extremely lightweight.
Right.
Power tongue jack here, your propane tanks go here, and you got your batteries there. We do have a very nice molded front cap, painted, beautiful, nice diamond plate rock guard right there. Coming on down here, it is prepped for the Furion side cameras, if you want to have that. And then here, we have some really, really awesome pass-through storage. Right there, we do have manual jacks,
okay.
But they are the quick drop jacks. Coming on down here, Asdel.
Nice.
J-Feather uses Asdel. Asdel's a composite and it will never delaminate on you. That's what sits behind the fiberglass. And it does have the Climate Shield Ultimate Weather Package.
There you go.
Now look at this small awning, but we have another awning with LED lights. Let's get them put out.
Okay.
What I love, Will, is that the awning buttons are right here.
Right, so you can see it.
And they're tangible buttons. They're not some iPhone, you know what I'm saying?
Yep.
And all you gotta do is hold them out as we get them all the way out. Bam, bada bing, bada boom, and we have some solid steps right here. Coming on down, we do have a cable-driven slide-out system, prepped for a TV on the outside with speakers. And then look at these tires, Will, they're the Goodyears, I love those. 225-75 R15 with these awesome blacked-out Jayco rims.
I do like those rims.
Looks very good, and I like the Goodyears, Will. Goodyears are phenomenal tires. Coming around the back, we do have a ladder to get up on the roof. Receiver hitch right there, good for a bike rack. You can't tow behind this, obviously. Outdoor shower there, and it is prepped for the Furion backup camera there.
Okay.
All right, and then right here, well, we do have 50 amp power right there.
Okay.
Coming around the side, Furion instant hot tankless water heater. Right there, you got cable, okay? And then coming on down, here's where we dump our tanks, black tank
flush.
Paradise,
I love how they're right next to each other.
Yep.
Like, it sucks when you have to have two, but at least they're both right there.
Yep, absolutely. City water connection, black tank flush. That's a place for you to store your sewer hose. You got a low point drain.
That's really nice, too, how they did that.
Yes. Potable water fill.
Potable.
And then here's the other side of that storage.
There you go.
Now, why is that so nice?
Well, like in mine, you have to climb halfway under it and then pull
it.
This, okay. It's right there. You know, you don't have to get on your knees or crawl under the RV or anything like that.
Well, Will, the outside of this travel trailer looks great, but the inside looks even better. Come on. Let's go. Take a look.
All right.
Take a look at the inside.
All right. We'll start up front. You have a nice bedroom here. This is where it's harder to get all the angles with the camera. Come on. Storage space there. bathroom right behind the bedroom. And then in the back is the living area, dining area, and kitchen entertainment area.
Perfect. And Will, before we show everybody inside, we got something real weird going on back there. But let's give a big shout out to the sponsor of today's episode.
Today's episode is sponsored by Lippert and their all new Curt Touring Coil Suspension. This is something brand new to the RV industry, and me and Jen had the opportunity to get it on our new RV. And let me tell you, it is one of the single best RV upgrades we've had yet. The suspension is truly part of the foundation of the RV, and it's so important because the stiffer that the suspension is, the more everything is gonna rattle. It's gonna cause problems in the RV, and it's also gonna cause for broken dishes and everything in the RV. Now, what's so great about the Curt Touring Coil Suspension is that it's using really high-end engineering. It's giving you 50% less shock on the road. And it's really gonna help increase the lifespan of the RV because, again, the suspension is part of the foundation. And everything above that is what's taking the stress based on how the suspension is performing. So every screw, every weld, every joint, all that doesn't have as much pressure on it. It's reduced by 50%. What's also really great about it is it's using superior technology and it's super reliable. And one of the best parts is it's reduced your maintenance by a lot. To learn more about the Curt Touring Coil Suspension, make sure to use our link down below and we'll have loads of information down there. Thanks again to Lippert for sponsoring today's video. Let's get back to the video.
All right, well, what the heck's going on here? We're starting back
I know
here.
What it is, I think.
You know what? This is probably part of the kitchen area. So I want you to begin, Will. What do we got going on?
I actually don't think it's part of the kitchen area. And it's not what I originally thought. I thought this was going to be like a desk.
Yeah, I thought so too.
I guess it kind of is. You would sit here.
Yeah.
It's not the best design I've seen, I'll be honest.
Okay.
And then I guess it just flips up for storage.
Okay. But what I love about this rear area is that it does double for countertop.
It does, yeah.
Just show everybody everything.
Yep, I'll open up all these cabinets. I'm going to try to avoid the up and down because I know that's what's
No, I got it. I mean, I can move it with my thumb. You just got to learn how to... Well, you didn't do much video games growing up, did you? You got to learn how to control and analog at the same time.
You got three windows around the back, which is really, really cool, especially if you have a nice view. Got a little pyramid of power. Power USB and USB-C. Drawers here.
Wow.
Right there. Storage right there.
Very nice.
And then, did I get that one already?
Nope.
Oh, hope so. Storage. Oh, no storage there.
Okay.
Fake storage.
Yes, sir. Windows all the way around, too, which is really nice.
Okay. This fridge... opens only one way. I thought maybe it was the two-way. Pretty good size refrigerator and freezer. Actually, it's really not. It's actually kind of small, to be honest.
Right, really big doors, though.
Yeah.
Gave you that illusion.
I did. Nice Envision microwave right here. Here's what I will say. All Envision appliances.
Hey, we don't care about Furion or Envision. Right. Just keep it all the same.
Nice Envision range hood right there. And a three burner Envision cooktop. Let's see if it has the red lights. It doesn't look like it does.
Dang nabbit, Envision.
You got the oven door right there. Drawer space underneath. More drawers. I will say this kitchen has a ton of storage, especially when you factor in that behind you.
Mm-hmm.
More storage over here.
Yes, sir.
What's really awesome, we'll get into this entertainment center later, but that also can double as more kitchen space.
Perfect.
Nice extension faucet here. Double bowl sink with up here. What is it?
Prism of power,
prism
Will.
Prism of power. Why is it a prism?
Oh, that's not a prism. That's a tower of power,
tower
Will.
Of power. I don't know why I'm drawing.
Well, no, yeah, but you were saying the P word, so
I
just rolled with you.
Yep.
Nice storage there.
And then to wrap it up. We got some drawers.
Two and three.
There you go.
Awesome. Now let me show you guys this dinette. Oh, man. Well, we're back.
Is it working now?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
You know what, Will? You know what I'm learning in my life?
What?
I get frustrated with things, and I go like,
yep.
BS. It's broken. It's stupid. It's like, let me just slow down for 30 seconds.
Look at it a minute.
Would you look at that? Okay. Check this out. We're looking at the dinette now. Look at this. I love the windows all the way around.
I know. It is so nice.
Okay. Flush floor slide. Storage underneath there.
Okay.
More storage underneath there.
Nice.
A dinette. Fat boy approved, Will.
There you go.
Oh, no, not too fat boy approved. Well, I guess. Yeah. Like, the bottom still hits that part there.
Yeah.
But again, you know, still pretty nice. I love all the windows all the way around. This actually drops down to make a bed. And then this is definitely like a cloth-style material.
Yeah.
It's different.
But I feel like it'd clean up decently, okay?
No vents in the floor, which I'm a huge fan of. And then here, we got these theater seats. And then look at this.
That's supposed to go on the other. Oh, no, that one's right.
I don't think so.
Yeah, other way.
They have these mixed up. Person must not be a real RVer. Excuse you?
What?
Why'd you say,
Because they're not a real RVer.
Oh, okay. I thought you were insinuating I'm not a real RVer.
Oh.
See? It has the curve for the stomach. I do love that.
Some people say you're not a real RVer.
Right. Who was it? That YouTube couple that made their own toilet tank treatment as well? Good job. Keeping it in. I might look like a bad guy for a second. Right there, we do have a nice mirror. Okay. Nice power USB and everything. And sitting directly across, Will, is a Sansui TV. Again, to Will's point, love how the countertop kind of extends out so you can double it when the TV goes down. Right there, we do have a very nice Inflame fireplace. And you know what, Will? We got power.
There you go.
So a lot of people are going to be like, why don't you ever put the awnings up or do this? It's because we're using a jump box and it's hard just to keep the lights on.
It really is, yeah.
That's why we love coming to the PDI Center. And then look at that. It drops down. Now we have all this countertop space.
There you go.
Well, do you know what time it is?
It's now time for the MSRP.
MSRP. On this unit here, oh, we didn't have the MSRP. So I got it off of Jayco's website. MSRP on a 27MK is starting at $53,550 MSRP, which is about right in my opinion. And that's going to be the depending on the options.
Right.
With that said, sale price on this unit is going to be somewhere in the low 40s.
Right.
Well, I don't care what the MSRP is. I don't care what the options is, and I don't care what the sale price is. Do you know why?
Why?
Because we sell Jayco towables in Michigan.
Right.
And if you guys are willing to come to Michigan to buy a Jayco, I promise you, nobody is going to beat our price.
Right.
All you got to do is go to generalrv.com/MattsCash. I've linked it down in the YouTube description below. You guys can get there from MattsRVReviews.com or call 844-969-4033. Y'all, please reach out to us. A member of our team will reach out to you. They will help you get one thing and one thing only. And, well, that is...
the best price in America.
Burr, 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 burr. All right, Will, go step in that shower.
All right.
All right, Will.
All right.
Man, I tell you, I tell you, it feels good having the camera angles back.
It does, yeah.
Talk to me.
Really good shower. Good width. Good depth. I do wish they turned the skylight the other way, but this is also okay. You still got good headspace. It passes. Bing!
That's a shower test seal of approval.
That's right.
Man, I tell you, man, technology's crazy.
It is.
Okay. Right over here. Porcelain toilet. Very nice. But, Will, this is not a prime pooping position.
Womp, a little womp. Tight there, huh?
Yep. No, I'm just... yeah, it's just a little tight. No big deal.
Okay.
Right over here. Come on through, Will. We got some storage there. Underneath the sink. Oh, and Liquefied, our brand of RV toilet tank treatment. Will, we're doing a promotion. Free toilet bowl cleaner for everybody who buys on our website, liquefiedrv.com. Any purchase, you then get free toilet bowl cleaner from now until November 6th.
Yep.
And we're doing a contest as well. I'm picking one person. I'm flying to your house, taking you out to dinner, and I'm personally going to clean your toilet.
There you go.
Go to liquefiedrv.com to enter.
Have you ever cleaned a toilet?
Can I... Nice. Storage underneath there. Come on, Will. I'm trying to keep this professional.
Okay.
Right here, we do have...
Andre's like, God damn, I want to win.
Dang, dude. Right over here, we got nice storage. Good hanging wardrobe there.
Oh, what? You pinch yourself?
Got me. Really nice storage there. Right here, this is where you do mount the TV. You got windows on both sides. Will, check this out. No slide outs in the bedroom. Look at how spacious
it
is. It's
very spacious. It's this space here.
Yeah, really,
honestly,
really nice.
The side-to-side space is the same, but like you can actually stand here.
I love that. Good storage underneath there.
And it is smart. I mean, at the end of the day, like you want a little bit of room in the bedroom.
Oh, yeah, definitely. You need to be able to get dressed and stuff. Pull me.
Hmm?
Pull me.
There you go.
Oh, man. That's awesome. Nice headboard.
Whoops. Sorry, guys.
And then some storage underneath there. Well, that's it. That's the review. That's the J-Feather.
Hold on.
J-Feather.
Hold on.
Oh, my God. Will, you're still not able to do it?
There we go.
Now, before you all leave, it's time to give you three things that we love about this unit, three things that we don't like about it. Will, what do you want to do first?
Let's do three things we like first.
Okay, like number one, I'm in it.
Yeah.
This bedroom is big, spacious, nice. Sugar, spice, everything nice. The size of this bedroom, it feels really good. I love what they did here. That's love number one. Will, what's love number two?
Love number two is when you account all this in here.
Yeah.
Like, I know that's kind of multi-purpose, but you have a ton of storage space in here.
Yeah. Yeah. That's going to be number two. And then, Will, I feel like I'm going to copy you.
Okay.
I'm going to say the amount of countertop space.
Yeah.
So you got the storage. I got the countertop. I think it's absolutely fantastic. And I love just the way it looks in here. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Jayco does an amazing job as always.
Right.
That's three things we love about it. Now it's time for three things that we don't like about it. May I go first?
Sure.
Well, this
is... Yeah, that's weird.
This is poorly executed, in my opinion. Just because you put one of those in, it doesn't make it a desk. What the heck's going on here? Like, none of it makes any
sense. That's just storage, I think.
The desk area doesn't make any sense.
Okay.
That's dislike number one. Will, talk to me about dislike number two.
Dislike number two, as much storage as it has in here, there is no pantry.
Oof.
And I think that's definitely something I would miss. Also, there's not a lot of upper cabinet that you could kind of turn into a pantry.
Okay.
So it's like, yeah, you could make that your pantry, but then you're kind of on the ground digging through everything. So.
Got it. That's number two. And then, Will, dislike number three for me. Do you have another one?
I do.
Oh, go ahead.
It's an old one, but a good one.
Ah.
It's a picker. And in this one, it's particularly bad. I don't know why. I think it sticks out maybe just an extra inch or two. And it's a travel trailer, so it's a little bit tighter here.
Okay.
And then it's pushing you back further into the cabinet. So toe kick's especially bad in here.
Bada bing, bada boom. I guess it's not always an advantage to have big feet. Now, do you, Will?
I guess so.
Well, Will, that's it. That's the video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Again, if you're interested in buying a Jayco, we do only sell them in Michigan, so go to generalrv.com/MattsCash. Here's the thing, guys. I promise you, if you're interested in buying a Jayco and traveling to Michigan, I will personally make it worth your while and make sure that you guys get a phenomenal price.
Yep.
Click the link down below. Let us know. Also, again, if you want me to clean your RV's toilet, I don't care where you live in America, buy Liquefied on our website. I'll be picking a winner on November 7th. And if you live in Hawaii, please buy Liquefied because I'd love for you to win.
There you go.
Will, what say you?
Guys, thank you all so much for watching. This is a good floor plan, and definitely a little different than just kind of the standard run-of-the-mill floor plans. Make sure to leave down in the comments below. Let us know three things you like about it, three things you dislike. Make sure to always smash the thumbs up button and subscribe.
Thank you, absolutely, yes, everybody, so much for watching, and we'll see you next time!